G'day guys, it's Pete Moriarty here, and we are covering how you can make sure that you keep your new year starting fresh. That is your financial new year. And so we are going to be going through a few different ways that you can get your tech stack cleaned up and ready for this time of year, starting with a fresh slate. I want to talk about Asana. We use Asana for all of our task management, and Asana is a great cloud-based online task management platform, and it lets you share tasks, projects, initiatives with your team. And what that means is that you and your team can work collaboratively and effectively together, and it allows you and your team to get your work done even from different time zones and different geographic locations. Now, how is this different to instant messaging? Well, it's not like busting in on people and annoying them all day long with your chats. How is this different to email? Well, it's not, you know, formal communication, and email is a bit messy to do tasks in because you get mixed up with customer requests and you end up stuck in your inbox all day long, and we don't like that. A task system is really the replacement for a big whiteboard that you've got in the office, which is like current projects. And that thing that tends to happen when you're delegating something to a staff member, is it done yet? Is it done yet? Is it done yet? Is it done yet? Using shared task management software means that you just know when it's done because everyone's kept in the loop of how a project is running. You can also do things like status updates and Gantt charts and all that other fancy project managing type stuff. So what do I do inside my Asana when it comes to the end of the year? Well, let's have a look inside my Asana and see what I've actually got cooking in there. So this is our strategic area of the business. You can see here we've got projects for all kinds of stuff, from our delivery team who are delivering projects to customers, to our internal finance team doing all their work, to our marketing team. We've also got all of our strategy for our leading of the business happening right here inside of Asana. So you can see here we've got all the different initiatives that we've been working on, and most of these are coming to a close at the end of the quarter. So you can see here a number of these are falling due today, and a number of our annual tasks are also falling due today since we are finishing up the financial year. Great, so what do? Let me show you exactly how we structure things. We have more in-depth videos on Asana specifically, but I'm gonna show you really quick how we structure things. I have one task, and that one task is basically for the whole year. We've got our goal, for us was to build our concierge member base to 477 members. And then we've got some details on kind of what some of our strategies are and, you know, other bits and pieces that are interesting to us. And then you can see under that main task for the whole financial year, we have separate individual tasks for our strategic work that we're doing inside the business. And then each sub area of the business, so our marketing team, our sales team, our finance team, each one of those guys will have an annual task for their area of the business. Makes sense, right? They all roll up to the kind of top level strategy, and you've got individual tasks for each individual area of the business. So let's go ahead and look into marketing. That is currently assigned to Angel, our amazing marketing manager. So again, we've got kind of like our top level strategy for our content and our marketing and our customer avatars and all those kind of things. They all sit there. And then we split out the annual marketing tasks. Some of them just kind of roll on for the whole year, but then we have some tasks that might be for the quarter. So we've got a different pricing update and a brand update happening for Concierge that's being rolled out currently. You'll see more of that soon. We had our COVID campaign, which was called Remote Revolution. Let's jump into that. And from here, we have all of our tasks in a particular quarter. This was all one particular campaign. If you caught our 8-week COVID campaign, you would have seen all of the videos that we were doing and lots of lives and other content all about remote work. So this is all rolled up in our Asana, and you can see right down to the campaign level. I can go to the annual level, and then I go to the executive strategy level as well. And they all kind of roll up into each other, which is really nice. Now, what do we do when we get to the end of the year? Well, what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna go to this this executive level here, and we're actually gonna close off this task. It's really important that when you close off a period, you close off the tasks and you kind of shut the book on that period. There will be some things within here that are not complete. You would have seen that some of those tasks were not yet ticked off. No one ever gets absolutely everything done on their to-do list. However, if you keep that one executive actions task open forever, then what happens is you'll find that your most important tasks will get done, the less important tasks will kind of get done, but you get distracted by all of the non-important tasks that are kind of like lingering on from the past. I have a bit of a saying that, your business will only ever feel about 80% in control ever. It doesn't get better as you get bigger, doesn't get better as you delegate more, doesn't get better as you work less hours. It will only ever feel about 80%, maybe 90% in control on any given day, because you're always going to have challenges and new things happening. And if you are overwhelmed by every single idea that you've ever had in the last 12 months staring you at the face as undone, then you're probably not going to be very productive in the work that you want to get done when it's time to start fresh and start working on next quarter's initiatives. So I'm not saying you delete them, but what I am saying is we kind of leave them in the past a little bit. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into our exec project and we're going to create a new task, and we will call this task financial year 2021. It helps if I can spell, right? So I'm going to open up my executive strategy. Let's try that again. Cool. And then from here, we're going to create the subtasks for FY 2021. Attract, right? Might be marketing. And I'm going to assign that to Angel. And then she's going to go ahead and create all of her subtasks and so forth for each area of her business. Now, this is the most basic overview of Asana that I could give you and show you guys. But the most important thing here is that we're turning over the changing of the guard. We're switching over to a new period and we're going to switch over to a new task. Now, what if you need to reference back to the old tasks? What if you need to maybe just check something that you had in the last quarter because we want to bring some data into the new quarter? Well, we can do that as well pretty easily. Let's open up our Asana again. Inside the description of this task, what I do is I actually mention the other one. So let's mention FY20. If I can find it, what's it called? It was called exec, funnily enough. There we go. Great. Okay. So I can mention the old one, and then with one button, I can just click through, get to that one. And then sometimes what I do is I mention the new one in the old one, FY 2021, getting really geeky here. Here we go. And then I can just like switch between them nice and quickly. Isn't that easy? Cool. So that's how I set up my Asana, and basically we filter down everything that we're going to do in the new financial year from there. And tomorrow is our executive planning day. We do a review with all of our leadership team and we look at everything that's happened in the last quarter and the last financial year. And then we're going to start planning out for the new financial year. And of course, once we've done that, then we're going to break that down into the quarter and then monthly and then weekly. And that's how we do all of our strategy. These strategies are from a book called Scaling Up. It's written by Vern Harnish. So if you're interested in getting amazing performance from your team and amazing strategic execution, thoroughly recommend you check out that book. Okay, let's check if we've got any questions that have come through. Come on, Jeremy is here. Thanks for joining, guys. Hope this is useful. If this is useful, drop a comment below and let me know if it's useful. All right, great. So next up, I want to talk about subscription overwhelm. And that is where bit by bit over the course of the year, you try out different apps. And if you've got bright, shiny object syndrome, then you're going to be signing up for new services all the time. And what happens is you end up with another 10 or 20 or 30, 40, 50 bucks a month on your card 100 times over from all the apps that you've signed up to and maybe aren't using. There's also the apps that are in the category of you use them once or you use them sometimes, but maybe they're just not quite right on the right plan anymore. And you could probably bump them off without really missing them too much. And so I want to save you some money. And so the simplest way to do that is to cancel your credit card. So do it right now. If you haven't already done it, this is a special peak trick for the end of financial year. Open up your internet banking and say, I've lost this card. Or at a minimum, you can just block it and, you know, wait for them to send you a new one if you want. But I just cancel the card and, you know, gives you a couple of days leeway while they post you out a new one, if you're allowed to go to the post office. And what that will do is it will cancel the recurring billings on all of those credit cards. Now, be careful that American Express will sometimes keep some of the old ones going. But most banks, definitely Visa and MasterCard, should cut all of those old ones as soon as you kill the old number. Now, what happens is you'll get the new card, and then bit by bit, you've got to be careful to watch your email, and itGenius will be messaging you as well, probably, to let you know that your credit card is not going through anymore, and you need to now update your credit card. And that's super simple. You decide whether or not you still actually need that app, and for the critical apps, you punch in your details, and then you're done. Pretty cool, huh? That's my little one for the end of the year to save you guys some money. Hope that is useful. Kimon thinks it's awesome. That is great. Thank you very much for the feedback. Okay, cool. So let's move on to the next one. We've done our subscription overwhelm. There's also the fact that you should review regularly the tech tools that you are using. If you are still using Zoom, maybe you could consider using Google Meet. Most of the features that you've got in Google Zoom are now available in Google Meet, including recording straight from your Google Meet into your Google Drive. Zoom can't do that. I really love that feature. Google Chat have now pretty much reached feature parity with Slack. And so for many business owners who are paying extra for a tool like Slack, or maybe they're still using the free plan, and if you're using the free plan on Slack, then eventually you'll hit the 10,000 message limit and then you can't search and you may be locked out of your old historical data until you start paying for it. Google Chat does everything that Slack does, including guest chat rooms. So you can now have external users joining your company chat rooms. So that is a really useful one that's been a popular request. So review the apps and tools that you're using. If you're still using third-party tools like maybe Dropbox, maybe you haven't made the switch right over to Google Drive, you're paying for a G Suite license, but you're not currently using Google Drive, why would you still hold on to Dropbox? You're just doubling up. Kill off all of those. Simple is always better. Even if there's one or two things that you're missing, like Google Meet doesn't have breakout rooms, but if you can live without them, then you can save yourself $250 a year that you would otherwise be paying to Zoom. So I would rather see more money in your pocket rather than money going out to the world, as long as it's still coming to Google, of course.